mean, they worked decently last time around, but like you were mentioning before, it's not an offlane that really pressures into the safe lane carry, and he can find a lot more utilities coming from the four roll where he stacks up camps. And that was something that, VP did decently for the Shadow Fiend. They stacked up that large camp a bunch and got him a ton of farm, but they didn't really open up any aggressive plays. Like, Weihar never got punished for playing very far forward in the lane, and they never contested. We've seen a lot of contests in the jungle where you go and steal people's stacks. There was nothing like that from Virtus Pro, even though they knew that the Nagasaren was still farming in there.
Ban coming out, Clockwork by VP. The Earthshaker, I mean, I think whether it's a four position or offlane, I'm still a bit concerned if VP continue this offlane Earthshaker, because DK Fobos, I mean, they run it so much, they're going to get punished like they did in game number one. They're going to get punished in these scenarios where you have a self-sustained carry that's able to bully out the offlaner and not really be punished. Still, though, the Earthshaker, whether it's a four or a three position, is valuable as a pickoff against the as a pickoff against the Nagasiren. So, I mean, we saw the way that that bottom lane team fight went with the Team Secret trying to push uphill.
Team Secret, where you want to go with this? Fourth ban, difficult. You could, I guess, ban out Dazzle. It's an annoying hero to deal with, even though you don't have any sort of instant nuke power out just yet. Dazzle Earthshaker has been sort of the staple of support duos for a lot of CIS teams. The fact you've got sustain and aggressive power. And keeping Lina alive, a lot of people see her as, okay, Laguna Blade's out, spells cast, that's it. She's blown everything, but she's got a lot of attack speed behind her once that fire assault starts to kick in. Queen of Pain is taken out.
Queen of Pain.
Four roll Lina, maybe they're expecting.
Yeah, I mean, coupled with the Earthshaker, whether as an offlaner or as another support, actually works as a pretty nice duo. Such a long range offensive power with that.
10 seconds remaining.
Third pickup for Team
5 seconds
Secret.
remaining.
Do they pick up? See, they want to leave their carry and their other support open. So they either go for the offlane or the mid at this point, right?
Spirit Breaker is not bad.
Spirit
Like Lina
Breaker.
Earthshaker are annoying, but the chasing power you've got to try and cause chaos is pretty good. Maybe you want to put that in the four roll, but
I think Tusk is pretty valuable
oh yeah, Tusk is there.
against Lina and Earthshaker. It's both good and bad against it. Like the snowball will group you up, so the Lina and Earthshaker may be able to get their AoE combos against you, but a lot of the times you can use it as a saving mechanism for the same exact situation. Tusk is also one of those offlaners that can go for a Glimmer Cape, which is pretty valuable right now. I think you want to look at those heroes. Maybe like Team Secret even dedicate a little bit more time to Pilotize Crystal Maiden to be able to get a Glimmer Cape just because of the opening of Lina or Shaker. If you have much more magic damage on the side of VP, Glimmer would be very powerful in the first 15 to 20 minutes. Team Secret using the rest of their reserve time to talk about this
Ooh.
third pickup.
They are dire side, so they could go for a TA here against the Lina. And then also utilize the Ancients and, rush taking capability of that. You don't really rely too heavily on jungle stacking or farming either, so you could still have a support or an offlaner that heads on in there. But what offlaner could we actually be. Okay.
Ember Spear, that certainly wasn't what I was expecting. The mid Ember Spirit does not work against Lina, so perhaps we're looking at a carry Ember Spirit. Maybe Team Secret are just going from the get-go and saying, you know what, let's just
Naga
lock it
support.
down. Nagasiren and Crystal Maiden supports. We're not
Okay.
gonna try and pull that tricky situation twice. Which I'm fine with. Again, like when we start off in game number one, we saw those two heroes. I was talking about how much I value them as a support duo, just
Yeah.
because I feel like they have a lot of synergy together. The Dazzle, you called it earlier. CIS teams love to be able to pick that one up. It works out fairly well against some of the aggression of Team Secret.
It gives you so much more leeway in team fights to make mistakes. You know, not that they want to make mistakes in the first place, but if stuff does go wrong, or if Team Secret gets the song, they set up for a fight, the dazzle with the weave, and then the defensive capabilities out from him can, you know, really turn a fight or allow you to get the extraction, get the heroes out of dodge. And Earthshaker kind of fills that role as well with a well-placed Fissure.
All right, so an offlane or a mid here. I wouldn't be still okay with the... Oh, Magnus. Okay, they're just going to go straight synergy with the Ember Spirit. I thought maybe they would go for a separate, like, kind of carry with the Templar Assassin that you were talking about, because there are Darkside, Ancients, etc.
They still could.
They could, and they would run, like, a Magnus offlane, right?
Yeah. I don't think it's great, but
yeah,
opportunity is still there.
You can still, with the Magnus, abuse Ancients because you have that early empower on the Ember Spirit. 10 seconds remaining. But you'd be putting all your eggs in one basket. And I feel like Ember Spirit is a kind of rough hero to go all in. I really like Ember Spirit when he has another carry behind him. So I actually would prefer the Magnus offlane, even though I don't think it's great.
Interesting they've picked Anti-Mage against two Ensnares. Frostbite and Ensnare.
Yeah, that's got to be tough. The Magnus as well. His mobility later on can be valuable versus the Ember Spirit, but...
You can get out of Naga and Snare now, though, with Manta. You never used to be able to, but you can now in Dota 2.
Dota 2.
All right, so the Storm Spirit's going to ban away by Team Secret, still thinking that it's going to be a different mid. Or maybe just hoping to force Alina to go mid. But again, I don't really see that much problem with Alina going mid. Bloodseeker, the last ban out from VP. So they actually do think it's a Magnus as some sort of three position and a potential for another core.
What is there to burn through a Tier's Refraction here? Nothing, right?
Yeah, not a whole lot. Poison Touch at best.
It's literally just the Magnus that I'm looking at and, you know, wondering, does Misery play that in the offlane? 10 seconds
remaining. Misery's, I mean, he's a pretty star all-around player. Windranger as our mid. Okay, so the safe lane, Ember Spirit, mid Windranger against what could be the Lina matchup.
There's a very similar situation to having the TA against the Lina, but this Windranger gives you a ton more power against the Anti-Mage. Shackle Shot plus Focus Fire. 20 minutes in, you can actually go around and solo kill the AM. I didn't even mention, you know, Searing Chains is another Ensnare that you can't blink away from. So they've got three.
Oh, yeah.
They've got three. Plus Shackle, plus RP. If Anti-Mage doesn't get fully babysat here by Dazzle plus whoever, they're going to have a really rough time, honestly. So VP need to keep there. Half of the map really, really well controlled. Warding has to be looking out at Roche Pit, because Roshan is definitely an early potential here with the Focus Fire from Windranger, the farm potential out from Team Secret.
I'm looking at this, I'm going, you can run this so many different ways, right? You can potentially still pick up another offlaner, another support, or different mid. What would be most valuable here? I'm thinking about control over the Ember Spirit. I want to get a little bit aggressive. I think Disruptor wouldn't be a bad support. He, like, in the laning phase, Magnus won't be able to really do much about that. It's a decent controlling hero for the Ember Spirit. And Windranger also potentially caught out by the glimpse. I think that the kind of aggression that Disruptor can offer you is quite strong when coupled with a hero like Lina, who offers you that sort of like instant numbers advantage by being able to one-shot one hero, and then the rest of the team has to back up, in which case you get a second pick off with a glimpse, right?
Honestly, do you want to hear my suggestion?
Yes, go ahead.
It's Techies.
Techies? Techies as what, like a straight offlaner, or it's like a four-position?
Like a four-position Techies.
So, like, run with the Earthshaker offlane?
Just buy space.
Buy space. But even then, like, time isn't necessarily a winner for VP here.
It's not... Guaranteed, no, and there are Naga illusions to actually go around demining and things like that. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I like that. A different source of control. Skywrath Mage, coupled with the Earthshaker, has some decent powerhouse long-range nukes. Same goes with the Lina. It offers you a silence versus the Ember Spirit if you catch him. I'm just really interested to see how this Magnus offline goes. Because that's the biggest concern right now for me as Team Secret. I like their lineup. I feel like it's quite greedy.
With Puppy, you know, we mentioned very early on into the draft of game number one the fact that Nargasaren has been known to run towards mid or offlane and help that hero out a ton with the Riptide and just run at the opponent heroes. Anti-Mage susceptible to this. The Scarth Mage tries to zone out the winner a bit, gets harassment down there. So the Nargasaren should have a good easy route down the bottom lane with the Magnus. Get him up to level 3. Get him a good amount of experience and try and allow for an easier laning stage, because it's never going to be easy. You can just try and alleviate some of the pain, maybe.
Yeah, I could see that. The poor man's shield, Nargasaren, is really tough to push out. So
yeah.
What if they run like full aggro in the beginning? Like they keep Pile I Die down here too. No.
Oh, but
I don't think there's too much value in Pile I Die in jungle. You need that level 2 as fast as possible. Maybe he could take advantage of the enemy jungle, though.
Maybe initial stages, because what have they got? And Snare level 1, if you want to go for that, over the Riptide. Frostbite, skewer back into tower, skewer back into death. Maybe not the anti-mage. You know, he's squishy, but he's still got that blink away and a poor man shield. But if you catch the dazzle, force him to go grave level 1, it's not great.
Because then I'm just looking at it and going, again, Earthshaker can't really punish the Ember Spirit if he's left solo. Yeah. So if you put Pylite Eye in the enemy jungle, he takes this hard camp, he picks up level 2, maybe he ganks one. Again, just kind of ensuring that Magnus gets his basic like level 3, and then he'll maybe be okay by himself. But doesn't look like it. Pylite Eye is going to be kept here at that top lane, making sure that there isn't going to be any pressure on the Ember Spirit. They're going to be having, obviously, Weeha as the mid lane Windranger, who's going to be matched up against God, who's playing the Lina.
One thing that DK Phobos has going for him, he's only got one clarity. He's not doing the usual block off the creep wave with Fisher. Is he doing
this is the same build that he goes for. The efficiency of it is, first of all, you're super tanky. Second of all, the efficiency allows you to go for Ring of Bacillus, which is really strong in the laning phase. Then you break that apart for the Soul Ring and the Tranquil Boots.
Yeah.
I like the power of that. I just feel like maybe it's a little bit too stat focused, and it leaves you in a situation where you just can't spam out for your Soul Ring like you would want to. And you also don't have like the boots advantage over the supports or something like that.
You can't go hunting and chasing.
But in this one versus one situation, it does work out very nicely because it's a right click war a lot of the times. So he's able to just kind of do battle with the Ember Spirit because he has that extra armor that you normally wouldn't see. And he's in a nice situation right now. He's probably going to pick up maybe level 3 for free, essentially, without being forced out by the supports at all. DK Phobos really thinking about going for the Fissure Block. He will be able to get a pretty good one here. He's going to get a lot of right clicks on Eternal Envy, choosing not to wrap himself around. And look at all that damage. Eternal Envy is going to be able to get out of here eventually, unless he gets really body blocked. DK Phobos, oh no! He missed one of his right clicks. He just kind of stood there for a little bit too long. If he'd gotten a right click and then ran and maybe gotten a second one, maybe he would have gotten the kill. But as it is, he's now going to have his clarity burnt away from him by Puppy.
Earthshaker cannot punish Ember Spirit unless Ember Spirit punishes himself.
Yeah, unless he gets that really critical Fissure Block.
Well, they were doing this little dance around the tier 1 tower, you know, Envy sort of getting in there with a flame. God, doing a little jive, but Phobos, it wasn't fazed by any of it. Now Puppy's coming in. No Ensnare, just the Riptide to force him back. But Ember has missed out on pretty much a full wave of last hits in comparison to Illidan.
Well, that's awkward.
And Lil is in visit mid.
He doesn't have any vision, right? I don't see any counter wards. So Weeha just threw out a shackle and just latched onto Lil. So that was just straight up like, free invis detection. There's an invis hero here. Misery is actually doing some jungling with Pile I Die. With the early aura, I could see how Shockwave spam would allow you to do a little bit. TK Phobos, he's gonna go down here, perhaps. Eternal Amp has to dive in deep. The burn slowly but surely gets the first blood. And EE walks away with an extra 400 gold thanks to that.
And Puppy just gives him some tangos. I really quite like this early point in Sleight of Fist. For the mid-Ember Spirit, you know, you very rarely see it unless you need that catch and you know you've got supports that are going to be roaming in for the Sleight of Fist into Chains combo very early.
Mm-hmm.
But on this safe lane, he's been able to, you know, try and dodge out from Enchant Totems, from Fissure. He's going to have that opportunity, but also DK Lovis is going to be sitting himself in a situation where sometimes he comes up towards the creep wave, but a lot of the time he's going to be sitting, you know, pretty far back. In fact, he can't see Puppy. He knows he's stacking, but there's always the chance that he comes in from the side. And FNG, are they looking for the kill? The Dazzle actually making a rotation up here.
It's a little brave. Maybe he's just trying to give more room to DK Phobos to actually really lane, offering that saving mechanism. But I don't think it's going to be enough a lot of the time. The combination, he just gets ensnared for way too long.
Oh, Puppy, he sees him.
Yeah. Not gonna go for him just yet. Eternal Envy isn't ready to
They're
run.
They're gonna
it.
Go for G at mid, though.
Oh, maybe.
Not having it. God, walks just the correct way.
Run straight down. In fact, if anything, Gotta can actually turn this one around. Light Strike Array? No, he just throws out the Dragon Slave. A little bit too dangerous at the low HP he's at. Power Shot does miss, and that'll set him up for some decent amount of success. Shackle Shot doesn't latch. Lil is dropping pretty low. Weehawk's going to try and commit to the kill with a Power Shot, but he doesn't bring him low enough. He knows it too.
If G had moved any other way, Frostbite plus Shackle Shot come out and he's dead. Because there's no Grave on FNG. There would have been a heal, a Poison Touch, but that's not enough to stem the flow.
This damn illusion's causing a decent amount of havoc to God's HP pool.
So do you think Magnus in the offlane goes for Tranquils plus Sol Ring? Because Tranquils is relatively unusual from what we used to see from Magnus anyway. You know, the Arcane's Rush, maybe a Bottle, then into the Blink Dagger.
Ooh, he had this kill. Oh, a no, Miss Skewer and a Miss Shockwave. Well, he had it. I mean, that was easily enough. That's what, 70 plus? That's 220 magic damage. Yeah.
Like, at that moment, if I was Lil, hands off keyboard, you know, like, I'm screwed.
Yeah. Unfortunately, that doesn't happen now with level 6 picked up by Eternal Envy. He maybe just goes in a little bit too deep. He's going to have to remnant himself away here, actually trying to focus on FNG before he jumps out. TK Phobos was actually running to the remnant at the time, really hoping to punish him more. But
yeah, he's going for the BOT's rush as well. No bottle, no real sustain on this lane. Does he go? Oh, he's buying a TP scroll. Okay, remnant down TP, regen back up and head back to lane.
Yeah, Boots of Travel is just too valuable on that hero.
I was wondering if you... Oh, he did go for the bottle as well. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And he fully buys out stats now. Gets the Ring of Akilla as well as the Magic Wand, so no real fast boots of travel. I'm sure he'll still go for
FNG.
It next. Yeah, he's dead. He denies the regen rune, but it's going to be shackled up. Power Shot, and doesn't even have the Shallow Grave to be offered. That's a little awkward. DK Bubble is also going to die here in the top lane, run down by Puppy and Eternal Envy. Facing his fate like a man.
So I guess Envy in this situation feels that there's been a lot of rotation up to top to try and deal with him. Like the two heroes that haven't really are the Anti-Mage and the Scarath Mage. Lina at some point is going to be heading up there as well. She's hit level 7 and Yule Scepter should be coming up in the next, you know, 4 or 5 minutes or so to set things up. It purges off Flame Guard, and if there's no Remnant down, he should be able to grab the kill over on the Ember Spirit.
True to a little bit of the older version of Team Secret. This team is getting so much farm on their supports. Like, the level disparity between these supports is massive. And TK Phobos, he may just die again. Eternal Envy is going to try and run him down. Ends up getting hit by that Enchant Totem hit. Still, though, FNG does have the Shallow Grave. He's going to have to pop it in the last second. Eternal Envy is dropping lower all the time. He's going to try and commit to the kill and still bounce himself out. DK Bubbles gets a little bit more, but Eternal Envy gets the kill. Now he's blocked in, and he won't be able to get out of this one immediately. He does have a Magic Wand, jumps away as he forced the TP. They really thought he was stuck, but Eternal Envy just baits that out.
Oh, the bait.
He had 11 Magic Stick charges, yep, too. It wasn't even close.
And then Paladai just moves in towards mid. Weehawk is actually stopping the rotation back. The easy rotation from G controlling top room.
Oh, Misery's dead. Cost of magic. Cost of magic, Illidan sunders that Rhino's Cabal. And they get themselves the first kill on the board, 8 minutes in. Net worth-wise, Animage is top, and sitting at 4k, Eternal Envy. Probably missing a decent number of CS while he's always trying to, you know, shut down that Earthshaker by aggressively pushing into him, but...
And if there's one hero, if there's one player you want on one hero to carry you through the game in your one position, it's Illidan on Anti-Mage, right? He has got, like, the records for most lasts, like 20 minutes, 30 minutes. He out-farms, outstrips pretty much everyone on this hero, given the right circumstances. And they are definitely setting things up for him. Stacking camps, building things up.
Oh, nice Fisher, actually. If he caught him on the right side of that, actually would have been a kill on Puppy. Or maybe a little bit sooner for FNG. Get some of that Shadow Wave damage. I will disagree with you there.
You want to say Miracle?
I was about to say, there's a new player on the field.
Well, see, the thing is, Miracle nearly broke Illidan's record 3 or 4 days ago. Mm-hmm.
But he died once. He died once and still almost broke the record.
I'm still going to say Illidan's up.
All right. At least we have a strong second place.
I like Miracle.
Oh, yeah. DK Phobos gets the Fisher. Gets the Fisher block. He'll get it on the staircase, or no, he'll just run down Pilot Eye. He knows there's no real escape for Pi in this direction, so...
Anti-Mage is here as well. Yeah. Four heroes for a little Crystal Maiden.
Poor Pi.
Oh. But yeah, Miracle is a pretty godlike player, honestly. Give him another couple of weeks. We'll see, you know... We'll see where he stands.
Our boots of travel for the Ember Spirit.
Misery, though, still not level 6, and he hasn't really been able to pick up any items. But Lil's being forced back by Puppy's Nagasaren, who is rapidly approaching level 6, has Arcane Boots, so they've got the Mana Sustain from her, as well as that level 3 Arcane Aura. Very often we see it stopped at 2, and then you either go into your Frostbite or Crystal Nova, more commonly the Crystal Nova for like the damage and the attack speed slow. But yep. Frostbite here against an Anti-Mage, I feel, is really imperative.
Yeah, that being said, there is so much value on the Frostbite. DK Phobos is going to be run down here. The TP in, FNG couldn't get the Shallow Grave out in time. So another pick off. Poor DK Phobos, he's just being fed away to Eternal Envy constantly.
Full 0-0.
But yeah, going back to it, I mean, you've got an offlaner that benefits from the aura a lot. The mid usually always benefits, like there's... not really any mid out there right now that doesn't benefit from the Crystal Maiden aura, but I think it's the fact that you've got
Eternal Envy playing so aggressively up on top.
Yeah, like you've got the carry who's constantly spamming out his spells, the offlaner, which is his only real way to get farm most of the time, is spamming out Shockwave.
Fisher and Concussive bot not going to come to anything.
Oh, they're actually going to TP to the bottom lane. This is going to be behind the fight. Lil's going to be caught here by this one. Jump forward. Eternal Envy going to catch God in the process. He's trying to get out. Light Strike Array won't go down in time until a Shallow Grave comes out. He's going to commit to the kill on Pylite Diet. Laguna Blade Dragon Slave just barely clips him, but it's just a Crystal Maiden and a triple kill for Eternal Envy, who makes perfect use of that Boots of Travel.
Holy crap. And he had a DD rune on Weihar as well. So this tier 1 town is forfeit. There's no glyph. There's nothing to keep it up and running. Illidan, he switched up the top. He's like 1,000 gold away from his Battle Fury, but Misery is here, trying to make his life a living hell.
He's silenced up, and now he may not have the mana to be able to skewer away. He's going to lose it, and the ultimate's up. There goes Misery. Pylon Eye sticking around a little bit. Remnant comes forward, trying to catch somebody. Will be able to catch Lil. Turns around, silence just before the chains, and Eternal Envy is actually very low on mana now. He's got to be a bit more careful. Slowed down, but there's more rotations out from the rest of Team Secret, so... not going to commit too much more Soul Ring on the Earthshaker alongside those Tranquil Boots, so you finally have some farming capabilities. Illidan, meanwhile, is looking for that 13-minute Battle Fury alongside Treads, which is still impressive as all hell. The Bounty Rune will make it that much easier for him, I guess.
But you mentioned the supports here from the Dire. You know, the Arcanes and then the mech is coming up quickly for Puppy. They've got the sustain, they've got these... I'm guessing it's mech because the Greaves are such a great item here the Silence of Skyrath Mage.
And you have an offlaner who can't go for mech,
yeah.
Guardian Greaves. The Magnus obviously needs his blink.
I mean, he could if he went Arcane Boots and then Greaves after after the blink, but...
yeah.
Like, the Tranquil still is an interesting choice for me.
Shackle Shot, Ensnare, RP, it's all available to shut down Illidan. And he was really the only big threat to Team Secret right now. They've shut down the rest of the enemy team pretty damn dramatically, and now they've just kicked back Illidan's farm by quite a lot, and Eternal Envy holds now a 700 gold lead over him.
Yeah, that 13-minute Battle Fury that was coming up is now completely stopped in its tracks. There's a Yule Scepter for G. He has a Staff of Wizardry already on him, right?
Yep.
So they've got the Yule Scepter, but who's his target? Who does he actually go looking for? He's just hit level 11, so this is pretty good timing. 13 minutes again. Once again, G has been on the money with his item timings and his farm rates in this series. But do you just want to kill the Magnus and the Crystal Maiden over and over again? Ember Spirit.
Looks like it.
It's not going to be easy.
Ember Spirit coming in from the side. They're going to play aggressively now into this middle lane. Misery's going to be caught once again, silenced up, and he will end up going down. They're keeping this Blink Dagger at bay. Puppy spreading out his illusions. Cancer all over the map.
Five heroes here from
Eternal Envy. He manages to catch FNG and will be able to kill him nice and quick. Jumps away to his remnant on the side.
The song from Puppy?
Puppy's trying to catch up to anybody. DK Phobos one step ahead. The sleeping wave doesn't quite reach him, and DK Phobos is out.
Just a little bit too quick. Now they turn quick on their heels.
Boy, that the fact that the dazzle went down so quickly there, thanks in part to the empower on Eternal Envy, he just dished out so much damage in such a short period of time. Jump away to the remnant. Fisher could still catch him, but they're not going to go for it.
Misery just needs to sit up on this top lane and get his Blink Dagger now. And hope that G doesn't come and Yule's Laguna Blade him into the ground. That's why he's standing a little bit further back.
I was gonna ask. Can he survive? But then I saw, that's a level 2 Laguna Blade, so he's dead.
And the Ancient Seal.
Yeah, just to give it that little bit of extra power.
Oh, slight misses. Oh, Illidan, Battle Fury time. Into the jungle you go. Start split pushing away. And I guess you go Vlad's here. There's no silence out from Team Secret. Mantastal would get you out of the ensnare, but if you're ensnared up, you're likely going to get shackled straight afterwards and held in place anyway. Just try and split push as much as you can. Allow the rest of your team to go and fight. That's a group of four.
Man, Eternal Envy is going to have such a fast Battle Fury on Ember Spirit. Like, usually he slows down and doesn't get it until like 25 minutes. That's good timing. But he's looking at like a 20-minute Battle Fury with Boots of Travel and all those other stat items.
It's relentless kills. A kill every 2 minutes. This guy is really being showing the aggressive play you can pull out with Ember. Because a lot of the time, you know, Ember mid, like you say, he has these sort of power spikes where it's very obvious ebb and flow. Staying passive early on, maybe getting up to level 6, 7, 8 when you can start, you know, trying to get up in the face with Searing Chains and Flame Guard. But from start to finish, Eternal Envy, utilizing every single ability to perfection. And TK Phobos with a little. They're going to find him. Ancient Seal, Mystic Flare. Yep.
Leading Fisher. No, he jumps away. He went for the 16-minute rune, gets the haste, and now he'll just run. Eternal Envy may even see an opportunity to turn and go for a kill here. Yeah, he's gonna remnant, jump onto DK Phobos. Lil is sitting on the side there. That's gonna be his target. The Fisher comes out. He's outside of the Skyrath Mage Ultimate, but he doesn't have any more burn damage. And managed to dodge the power shot there just in time. Weeha threw that one over from the middle lane. That would have been such a huge pickoff, though. That would have allowed Animage to get ahead of the Ember Spirit once again. Doesn't happen.
But Virtus Pro, they really are just trying, scrambling to control these tier 1 towers at mid and top. You just see them all swarming around, TPing in to try and control.
Oh, that's a pick off. We are. He's just going to be comboed down. God doesn't have a mana for Laguna Blade. Oh, and now the sleep. Oh, Jesus. This is going to be a 3-man RP if they set this up right. DK Bubbles has to hit the Fisher before it. No, the RP. Misery's too slow, but oh, Shackle Shot comes out. Still latching down two. Two supports go down. Misery whiffing that one. Just throws it a little bit too early. And misses out on the kill on God because of that, but...
Poor Misery, he can't find Blink Dagger, he can't find RPs. We worried about Magnus in the laning stage, but honestly, it's just the game. It's not the player. Like, it's honestly not the player, except that one moment there.
Yeah. that time it was definitely the player. Aghanim's halfway through for Lina, has 1500 gold alongside the point booster.
Yeah, but Windranger has 1500.
And look at that, an 18-minute Battle Fury for Eternal Envy.
Really?
That's so fast. That contests with... That's probably got to contest with most Battle Furies on Ember Spirit straight up. Like, even the ones that are kind of rushed.
And he with the old, like, Phase Drums bottle build, you kind of expected a 25-minute Battle Fury, right? From, like, mid-embers, because they go fighting, they'd miss out on a lot of farm. Eternal Envy, though, 123 last hits. The 9 kills definitely help. Definitely help boost up his gold a ton.
Oh, yeah.
6 to 12, though, 18 minutes in. And Crystal Maiden, you know, Pyladar just runs around placing observers and sentries, while Puppy actually gets a ton of farm. His mech's completed with the Arcane Boots.
Watch the Ancient Stack just start disappearing.
Bye, boy.
That's Empower, which is at what level? Level 3, because he only went for level 1 Skewer. I love this build. And then a Battle Fury as well. Like, 2 Sleight of Fists, and it's practically dead.
Eternal Envy, screw your smoke, I want to farm Ancients, the dragons.
Yeah, the rest of the team can go ahead and smoke up. He will bounce up to top lane to continue to try and split push. So 10k by 19 minutes, 10k by 20 is considered a fast farming hero, but Ember Spirit isn't really known to be that much of a fast farmer or anything. He's just been doing that well, getting kills. What's the kill? DK Phobos, he's definitely dead. I thought they were going to jump on the Ember Spirit at top lane, but that doesn't work out for him. And then with the kill, he forced rotations up to the top lane. They got a kill in the bottom lane. This is well set up for Roshan.
That Shackle was interesting, though. That angle was a little bit wide, but yeah, Roshan, in they go. I don't have Medallion right now. While I die, I guess we'll look to pick that up. Maybe Puppy, but Greaves, Blink Dagger, Force Staff, Glimmer Cape, those are things the Nargisaran really wants to get on into. So, Paladai can think about the Medallion Silvercrest. Illidan, Vlad is done. I haven't taken a single tier 1 though, and tier 1 defense here is really Secret's strongest point. Sleight of Fist, Song, RP now, they've got the Blink, Eternal Envy's jumped on here.
They don't have enough damage, even with the ultimate of Illidan, they haven't brought Eternal Envy nearly low enough. He's gonna catch Lil, gets the turnaround kill quite easily. Animage is forced back. They needed another stun. If they had another stun to be able to keep... the problem is right now that Skywrath Mage Ultimate, and this is a large reason he's dropped off from the support pool, is that increasing the duration of Mystic Flare hurts the solo kill Skywrath Mage so much. Because you really need a second disable to be able to get the full duration of Mystic Flare. Pylite Eye is going to die. Die. Misery, kind of trying to respond. Fisher goes down. They're going to still maybe catch DK Phobos. Gets a chains onto Illidan. They have the 2 supports sitting on the side. Puppy and Weeha are going to come in from the side. They're going to run right into God, get the needed shackle shot. He's dead, even before the shallow grave can get there. FNG just runs straight into death, certainly. RP catches DK Phobos. That's actually a more valuable kill than FNG. They're going to try and lock him down as best as possible with the ensnare and another shackle shot. That'll be quite easy for them. And FNG, he's also going to die. Cleaned up by Eternal Envy beyond godlike by 21 minutes.
Now, I'm guessing Manta's next for him. He could go for the damage build, but just to be safe against the Ancient Seal, I think, is the biggest thing here. Manta style would be that good defensive item.
Oh, we got him! No. I don't think that's a kill, but still, that was...
No Frostbite. If they had Frostbite there, then it's it. But it was cooling down for another 2 seconds.
He had to lead with a Frostbite right before the Animage blink, just to have an opportunity to get that kill. I can't believe we pulled off that Shackle, though.
Actually, what do you think Envy's going for? He goes for the crit, okay.
Yeah.
So I was wondering, because it's Envy, it could be Lincoln's, could be Skadi. Mantastyle would be, like, probably the safer midway item between defensive and offensive.
Yeah, specifically against the Skywrath Mage Silence to be able to dispel that one.
Lil, run as fast as you can. Is it going to be fast enough, though? They're really on the rampage.
Oh, he found him. He's silent, but still to double damage with the skewer on top. Lil's not getting away. Maybe he could drop enough damage. Weeha may actually die. Dragonslave actually misses. God's still going to be able to hit the Yule Scepter, but a sleep comes out. Now the team, they don't have RP. They're not going to turn this one.
Shackle Shot is going to latch these two heroes together. Maybe they will turn this one. They easily get FNG. The Echo Slam gets laid out. Gone, struggling to be able to survive, but he's surrounded by so many heroes. He's so dead. Pylodeye dropping the ultimate, forcing the Animage back. Eternal Envy getting ahead of Illidan as best as possible. Is going to be able to run into him with a chains in a second. Oh, we missed it. Just barely an Illidan. He's going to try and go for the kill, but no, it's not enough.
What?
Now he gets it. The right clicks are there. He's trapped inside of the trees, and beyond godlike, Illidan gains 1,400 gold off of that kill.
What?
Almost 2,000 gold swing just for that one versus one.
Oh my goodness. Tis mine. Eternal Envy. It looked like such a great play.
Oh, yeah.
But I missed chains.
Yeah, it's so hard when you don't actually have vision of the hero. You have to get the exact timing of Sleight of Fist and Chains.
The Crystal Maiden, who had, you know, almost nothing, is now out farming, out net worthing the Earthshaker, who is in the offlane. 4DK Phobos, Blink Dagger, a Pipe Dream, so far away. So far away. Well, you've got Glimmer Cape for Crystal Maiden, pretty much completed. Naga Siren. What's actually coming for her? Oh, there we go. Guardian Greaves fully completed. I knew she had a ton of money, but I couldn't see it. Guardian Greaves is done. And Misery, when's the big RP coming, Cap? When can we expect this? Is it now? Because the push from VP is actually aiming towards the tier 1.
I was going to say, it may never be needed at this point in time. Eternal Envy, Weave, silenced up. They can't really turn on to him. In fact, if anything, they're playing way too aggressively. As FNG is going to be caught because of that skewer back, Yule Scepter, maybe they can kill Eternal Envy. Slide Fist dodge. And now FNG, somehow he's still alive, but he's going to be caught eventually here. Finally, he goes down.
Blink is ready for Misery. And they're actually going forward.
Illidan, he's going to be chained up instantly, Manta, but the Shackle Shot, it does land onto God. Illidan actually bounces himself away from this fight to sight how low Weehai is. Two-man RP, maybe that's exactly why DK Phobos trying to line up for some sort of Fissure, but it's just too late. Those heroes are gone, and Illidan is unable to respond with anything there. Already threw out his ultimate. They took away the Aegis of the Windranger, but it just isn't enough.
Yeah, it was expiring like 30 seconds, so that's perfect timing for Secret. They wanted to get rid of it. They knew they could get some value out of it. And it's just that, another couple of heroes. Illidan, he's basically the lone survivor out of all of these fights. Anti-Mage, the one-man band. But he's not the best at quelling a high ground push here. With Windranger having focus fire, the spam of slight, the threat of Magnus RP with a force blink that he's actually getting delivered soon. There's so many ways for Team Secret to get up.
Yeah, they really only have DK Phobos and God to spam out the push, and Illidan just has to go for the split push constantly, but it's really not where you want to be. As Eternal Envy is always going to be able to deal with the split push decently well. Turn, got to be careful. Shackle Shot, what a beautiful bait. Eternal Envy and Weeha, their communication is on point right now. And Illidan, I think he's just in desperation mode where he feels like he has to go for a kill like that. Otherwise, if he's not allowed to split push, what help do you really have?
Well, he's got 3 kills, 2 deaths, 2 assists. And if you get that kill, you know, you can push out the lane as well. I think that's what you're really looking for. You're just trying to bridge the gap here, because even without a Naga Siren. Oh god, G.
Yeah, they're going to ensnare him up. They don't even have to use the supports to kill him. Eternal Envy will gladly take that gold away from the support's hands. And hey. Windranger, there's a Dazzle kill as well. Magnus in power, allowing the Windranger to dish out so much damage already. That's 200 damage a shot with zero reduction now that he's level 16.
Team Secret. Daedalus for Eternal Envy. We'll run the courier.
Is it Daedalus to finish off for our Windranger as well? Yep, it is. Demon Edge coming in.
Oh,
not the full Daedalus just yet, but still, even more damage for Weeha.
Okay, now this is the moment.
Now 250 damage a shot.
Double damage rune on Eternal Envy.
Oh, Jesus, DK Phobos. Just one slide of fist almost brings him out. Misery misses the skewer there. Will be brought back. Oh, Jesus! A critical comes out, 1100 damage, and pop goes the weasel. Good lord. FNG just disappeared. Team Secret, they're going to be able to take the tier 3 tower and keep on going. Melee Rax, next target. Eternal Envy fearlessly pushing in. He's like, somebody show their goddamn face so I can Sleight of Fist them.
Well, that's G.
Sleight of Fist, not going to happen. Eternal Envy, no!
The RP, Misery, you... Now, come on. Come on. You going to go for it?
Blink RP.
Blink Skewer.
There it is. Oh, no, the silence. Nice play from Lil. Laguna Blade goes out, but Jesus, Weeha just...
Roger that.
Pierces the Lina's heart. And Illidan.
Void? It's not. It's gonna take another like a third of his health.
Yeah, he's got a lot of mana. Maybe he can burn through the rest with a couple more right clicks, then pop that ultimate. It's still just not enough. And you know it too. Meanwhile, in the fight, they're actually taking out both of them. Sleight of Fist ends up going down. Illidan's still desperate to be able to get a kill, but Weehaw's just running around. Finally, the ultimate to finish him off. That's a godlike spree. Illidan has got a beyond godlike spree as well as a godlike spree. He's gotten so much gold. Now Turtle Envy's going to go. DK Phobos finds that opening, hit by the skewer, will end up going down because of that. Illidan, meanwhile, has the haste room, but ensnared up, won't be able to pursue. Meanwhile, and for some reason, with Illidan just being able to run down these heroes and getting that godlike spree, I almost feel like the fight was worth it. Just because it speeds up the progression of the Animage's farm. Obviously, losing your
full lane of racks.
Your full lane of racks at middle lane is not, it's not great, but
that the creeps with one Narcissar and Illusion were there for a good 30 seconds, just like, you know, humming to themselves, we're going to take the racks. No. No one's stopping us. Everyone's running through the Radiant Jungle looking for kill after kill, trying to force Team Secret back. But I don't feel like these deaths mean too much. You know, again, it's a pretty nice gain for VP, but it's not a big loss to Team Secret.
Oh, yeah.
And it felt like this last game. They find these seemingly big pickoffs. You know, in a lot of other games, we think, okay, highest net worth hero dies. Gold gets taken by the Anti-Mage. He's going to be able to get himself this next big item. But what is his next big item? What's the game-changing pickup here for the AM?
It's got to be Abyssal, right? Like, you have to have some sort of lockdown against the Wind Ranger and the Ember Spirit. Sell it, get the... Oh, man, he's not going for it. He's going for the MKB against Wind Ranger.
Yeah.
I can understand that, but I kind of felt like the huge damage increase and lockdown of the Abyssal Blade against Ember Spirit would have been so valuable. If you could start solo killing Ember Spirit when he's trying to stop your split push, that then forces Team Secret to bring two heroes to every single time you split push a wave. And that just means a lot more resources available to VP.
Roshan's up in a minute, though. And Puppy got himself that solar crest. Paladai trying to get into a BKB. He's got the four staff glimmer. So these freezing fields, we've seen three of them now, where after the song have done a ton of damage. But up at top is that EE, gets himself back down to bot.
I swear, I was like, DK Phobos, if he blinked in and revealed Envy there, I just would have lost it. Look at the vision spread though from Puppy. Being a good support, using his illusion, spreading out all over the map, plus he got an illusion rune. So he's got vision everywhere. And they're chipping out this tier 3 tower really fast. Eternal then immediately blinks into God and jumps himself back outward.
Yeah, Naga not only defending lane top with an illusion, but cutting the wave top as well. Had to be cleared out by Illidan as he runs himself over there.
Scouting out Roshan, which they know has to be up in the next like 30 seconds, guaranteed. So there it is. The big boy finally shows himself, and with a Daedalus on Weehaw, that should be really easy for them to take. 200 damage without the Empower. And that Solar Crest, good God.
Right, Misery has all the tools at his disposal to land a reverse polarity.
He doesn't have a BKB. That's the one thing. Last time that he got stopped, it was because Skyrim.
He just bought one.
Oh, he does?
That's what I'm saying. He just got a BKB. So like,
I was like clicking on him. I was like, yeah. All right, BKB, there's no silence, Misery. This is your shot. This is your one opportunity.
Yep. That's it. Come on. Show us.
Give it everything you got.
Show us the ultimate ability from the Magnus. Ridiculous damage from
Eternal,
Spirit, honestly.
Yeah.
Plus 229.
He's holding on to a Demon Edge right now, but I think he's going to go for a second Daedalus once he sees there's no Butterfly out from Animage.
Yeah, you rarely want to go MKB on Ember anyway, because you're not very often going to find yourself in a man fight 1v1 against the Anti-Mage, unless, like you mentioned, the Abyssal Blade would have kind of forced that.
Mm-hmm.
But EE just wants to keep doing this. Blinks forward. Sleight of Fist to catch any stragglers who are trying to retreat from the racks up here. But Weehaw with Aegis. The Soul Crest will be popped up onto him. They've got Greaves behind. Song to reset.
Oh boy, that was a complete whiff. Weehaw jumps just ahead of the Fisher. Now Lil's going to end up, not going down. Ember Spirit actually jumps back to his other remnant. They're going to give up this lane of racks, it seems.
Ant-Mage not finding their opening.
Like, Ant-Mage is waiting for his moment to strike. He's hiding up in the trees just north of Team Secret, but there's no opportunity yet.
Yeah, it's very odd.
And they know he's there.
Are they going back in, or is this just a cover? Yeah, this is just a cover.
I think Team Secret are a little bit of loss there. Puppy's like, they right. gotta be initiating somehow. Like, they can't just give us a free lane of racks and not have a plan. They're not split pushing. They're not doing, they're not gaining anything out of this. So they gotta be fighting us somehow.
It's like, where's the AM? I'm pretty sure that Eternal Envy just spamming that over and over again. Like, where is he? Because they have no vision of him. They don't know where he is. They don't, he's not split pushing. He must be farming jungle, but why would he be farming jungle? He could have maybe tried to take the tier 1 mid and backdoor that. But nothing gained there from Virtus Pro, not a kill, not a trade, not even a little bit of map control from the anti-mage pushing himself out.
Yeah, VP, no, they essentially have one last fight in them. And I think they just didn't see an opportunity in that bottom lane to go for that fight, so they essentially have one more shot with Team Secret pushing in the top lane, see where they...
It's risky to push this far out, though. They're gonna get scouted by these Naga Illusions.
Yeah, that's not real. They jump onto an illusion. MKB is complete for the Amber Spirit. Okay. So, certainly not going a butterfly now on the Animage, that's for sure.
All right, this is their window.
The trap has been set.
What a beautiful window it is.
So the creep wave pushes forward, it clashes in just the right area. They can go for the quick kill on Weiha. Oh, there, bye-bye, Lil. Now they jump out, Eternal Envy is shown in his face. They don't want to go on Weiha because he still has the Aegis. Now the Echo Slam, jump in, Misery almost gets eliminated, but the Glimmer Cape is actually saving. Now DK Fumbles can't get a Fissure to save his life. The RP gets laid out to finish him off, and Suicide goes out, but what does it matter?
That's it.
You've lost 4, Team Secret. Now push forward. What a dominant victory by them. They're going to go for Lilith and Illidan now.
Unless Illidan can get a 5-man. No.
Waits for the opportunity for the 5-man ulti, but it's not enough. And that's it. Team Secret.
$45,000. And VP walk away with 22.5 grand. You know, not a shabby second price for qualifiers.
No,
but both of them
not.
Go to China. Both of them go to WCA in China.
Man. People were hyping up.